Happy Independence Day to all. Happy Independence Day to all. Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel. I'm Bilobel Academy and myself Akash Babuji. And today I'm going to discuss about some problems faced by the Indian leaders after getting independence from British. So Indians get independence from the colonial rule of the British on 15 August 1947. It was a day of enjoy as well as trouble. You can understand that it was a day of enjoy. So you may have questioned that why it is a day of trouble for the Indians. So let us know about the problems faced by the leaders of India after getting independence from the British. So first one is partition of the country. So in the Britishers demanded that India should be become partitioned into several countries to become an independent country. So for this, Indians partitioned the country into countries like Pakistan, Afghanistan and India, and another country is Nepal. So partition of the country, peoples want to see their future in both the countries. People start roaming all the countries which are divided from India. So government of India means leaders of India suffered very lot to provide shelter, food and other basic needs for refugees. The number of people who arrived in India was more than the number of people who have went to Pakistan. So the second main problem is integration of princely states. The meaning of princely states is the states which was under the control of the British rule. So it is a big problem to Indian leaders that integration of princely states to the Indian government. So before the independence, there are 562 Indian princely states under the British control. After getting independence, these princely states starts hesitating to join Indian federal system. After this situation, some princely states, means almost all princely states, joined the Indian federal system. Some states like Junagadh, Kashmir, these both are in the north, and in the south, Hyderabad. These three states refused to join Indian federal system because the Indian government decided to send some military force to these three states to take under their control these three states. So the leadership was taken by the Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, who is known as the Iron Man of India. He went to these three states and attacked these three states. As a result of this, these three states come under the Indian federal system. This Junagadh was under the control of Mahabad Khan, who was a Muslim ruler. So he has decided to join Pakistan state, but his Diwan refused to join Pakistan state. He noticed Indians to sent military force to the Junagadh, and Junagadh joined Indian federal system, and Kashmir also like that only. And Hyderabad, this was ruling by Nizams. Nizams decided to become independent by refusing. This was refused by local Jamindars and common people. So they were start revolting against the Nizams. So they also noticed to the Indian government that to send the military system to Hyderabad and capture the Hyderabad. So on the leadership of the Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, all the princely states come into the Indian federal system. So the third main problem is economic status of the country. So this partition of the country and the colonial rule of the British made economical system of the country lost very deep. So partition of the country made refugees to roam over the three countries. So this is also the reason for the economic status of the country, which was very low at that time. And another reason is colonial rule of the British. It was mentioned in the book written by the Dadabhai Nauroji, namely the grain theory. The example for this is, take the example of cotton. So Britishers take the cotton from the farmers in the form of the tax or any form.
So they will send those cotton to their countries, and they prepared very well cloths compared to our nation cloths in the by the help of the machine. So these cloths were attracted by the Indians, and they starting purchasing them only. So because of this, industries come into existence, and industries of the British come into existence, and industries of Indians become extinct. So Indian leaders have to look after industries, trade, and other commerce properties to overcome the economic problems of the country. And the fourth problem is preparing the constitution. India get independent from the British, it become independent country, so it has to prepare its own constitution. It become challenge to the Indian leaders. So because of this, they roamed many countries and see their situation and their constitution, and decided to provide a constitution for the Indians. Because of this, many meetings were held, and finally drafting committee was formed under the leadership of Dr. V.R. Ambedkar, and finally resulting this, India constitution became the largest written constitution in the world. And the fifth problem is protecting its freedom. India has faced many problems due to the colonial rule of the British and other Europeans from 300 years, means 3 centuries. So to prevent the these type of situations in future, they provided to protect their freedom very strongly. Because resulting this strong military force was built, and nowadays our military force become fourth largest military force in the world. And the fifth and the last one is discrimination. Discrimination is a natural evil for the Indian society from ancient times only. Discrimination means discrimination on the gender, caste, and other properties. Discrimination, it was also how to control by the Indian leaders. For this, they have to establish new foreign policies to overcome the economic problems of the country. Because of this, India discrimination was controlled. And nowadays, India become the largest democratic country in the world. Like this video, share and subscribe for our YouTube channel for more videos, and share your experience about this video in the comment box. Thank you.